बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, हियर वी आर गोइंग टू कंप्लीट आवर सेकंड रिव्यू इन विच वी हैव कवर्ड अबाउट इंस्ट्रक्शंस एंड इन इंस्ट्रक्शंस वी हैव डिफाइंड द स्टेटमेंट्स एंड वी हैव डिस्कस्ड द डिफरेंट स्टेटमेंट्स दैट वी हैव गॉन थ्रू during the classes. Now we are ending up with the next and last statement, that is for next statement. For next statement is actually a loop structure in which we repeatedly execute the body statements, our set of statements that we need to execute repeatedly. So in order to save the time, we use the loop concept in which we type only once the body statement, but we can execute these statements repeatedly as per our requirement. So in this case, here is the syntax of the structure, which starts with the line number, then reserve word of for, and variable is actually the loop variable, which is initialized with certain value of x, and it will go up to the value of y, and it can be incremented with the step integer. And then comes the body of the loop, which will be repeatedly executed. And this structure ends up with the next statement, which has another line number and has the variable of loop. All this can be easily understood with this example code, where we have the line number of 30 from which for statement is started. P is the variable of the loop, which is initialized with 1, and it will go up to 10. Then the increment is with the step statement, and increment is actually of 2 integer, means every time P will be incremented by 2. It can be incremented by 1, 3, or with any expression increment, it is also possible. So in all this step, actually a condition is checked that body of the loop will be executed till the value of P is less than 10. As the value of P will be incremented to the value that is greater than 10, then the condition will be terminated and control will be shifted to the next statement after the loop. All this can be easily understood with this table, where we have the counter variable of P, which is initialized at once with 1. Then it will be tested for the condition of less than 10, means current value of P, which is 1, is less than 10, so condition is true. Then in this case, the body statement of Pakistan will be printed. Here you can see that we have the line number 40 with print statement to print the Pakistan as a body of the loop. Clear? So when P is initialized at first time, P value of P is 1, it will be tested with less than condition of 10. Condition is found true, then body will be executed and first time Pakistan will be printed at the screen. Then what happens? Control will be shifted back to the for line, where what happens? Increment will happen. Means at the for loop, you can see that there is step statement. Means at the same line number, we have two reserve words of for and next, for and step, which step increment will be done for P value. Then current, when P is 1, it will be incremented to 3. When it has the increment of 2, now new value of P is 3. So we will test, interpreter will test the condition of less than 10. Condition is again found true at second time and Pakistan will be printed. As the Pakistan will be printed and we have the next line number of 50, where we have the next statement, it will shift back the control to the for loop. Statement means line number 30. So at line number 30, again step will be done, means value of p will again incremented from 3 to 5. And next time p condition, p is checked for less than 10 value, condition again found true as 5 is less than 10, so Pakistan will be printed at third time. So in this way p will be incremented till 9. It is found true, then Pakistan will be printed at fifth time. Now when control will be shifted back to fall line, step will occur and 9 plus 2, now the value of p is 11. With this increment, when condition is tested it will found false. Then what happens? Control shift to the end line number, means then end statement will be executed. So in this way Pakistan will be displayed or printed on the output screen for how many times? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 times. Clear? We can clarify ourselves with another demonstration in basic language. Let's go here. Here is our basic language interpreter. We have loaded our program just to display it. Here you can see that we have a program, simple program, which has line number 10. At line number 10 we have CLS statement, then 20 where we have for loop. Its variable is I, which is initialized with 1 and it is going up to 10. Here we don't use the statement of step, although we can use it. And in body statement we have printed Pakistan as up till the value of I is found less than 10, Pakistan will be printed, but it will be terminated as the value of I will go up to 10, above than 10. So here we are going to execute our program with the run statement, and you can see how many times we have printed Pakistan. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. We can change this execution, means we can choose the step statement to minimize this number of printing of Pakistan. For this purpose we will use the edit command. How we will use this edit command? Just to list down your program and now use the edit command to edit your line number 20, and here we are just adding step statement for 3, means every time value of I will be incremented with 3. Now execute this program and we can see that we have now 4 times the Pakistan over here. Hopefully this demonstration more clarifies you about the for loop and its function, but still if you have any issue you can ask me. I'm here to facilitate you. Thank you very much. In the next review we will go for the topic how to launch the GW basic. Thank you very much. Love this.